Let's also now talk about what the Prime Minister is doing today. He's going to be holding an online meeting with the Indian Prime Minister, Narendra Modi, today. This as G7 foreign ministers meet face-to-face in London today to discuss security issues. Dr. Jade McGlynn is Director of Research at the Henry Jackson Society and joins us. Good morning to you, Jade.
Good morning, Julia.
Thanks so much for joining us. Now, we talked to Liz Truss a little bit earlier, the International Trade Secretary, about this $1 billion trade deal, the starting point of a full free trade agreement, let me get the words out, with India. But there'll be other things other than trade on the agenda, won't there, for the Prime Ministers of India and Britain when they chat today?
Yes, certainly. First and foremost, presumably, the devastating situation in India with COVID infections, where they've recorded more than 20 million COVID infections. And clearly the UK has stepped up to offer some help, although I don't believe that the Indian government still has to request vaccines, hasn't done that. And as a result, we also haven't provided vaccines, but I would be very surprised if given the situation in the country, that was not on the agenda.
And yet we know, I mean, even the Labour Party sort of haven't been talking about doing that officially, which suggests that perhaps, you know, the focus groups on both sides are telling people that that's not what people want. I do think everyone needs to bear in mind with India, those numbers are devastating. The problem in India is the lack of proper healthcare availability rather than the COVID infections. Their COVID infections per million people and their deaths are a fraction of what most of Western Europe has had in the last year. Absolute fraction, although it's going up. There is some evidence that it may well be flattening out, which would be a wonderful thing. But we are talking about it's a huge country with a huge population, a fifth of the world's population. So when you look at those numbers, they are on the face of it huge, but per capita, they wouldn't even pass, you know, it wouldn't be discussed in Europe, which is quite extraordinary. But the security is a big issue, isn't it? Among the G7 ministers that are meeting, and we know that the foreign ministers were meeting yesterday as well with Dominic Raab. There are lots of issues on the agenda, particularly regarding China and regarding Russia as well.
Definitely. And of course, China is a country of concern to India as well. So I imagine that will also be a topic during the meeting with Modi. However, much of the sort of run-up or lead-up to the G7 foreign ministers meeting today has been around the need to tackle shared challenges and rising threats and all of this sort of sometimes euphemistic, sometimes not euphemistic language that's essentially about the problems caused by Russia, China and Iran. And there's also been a lot of discussion about the need to tackle Russian propaganda and disinformation, although some of the measures that have been described for it are not particularly confidence inspiring, but still it's good to see that it's on the agenda.
Yeah, I think it's just good to see that people are having these meetings. I think, you know, good to actually have some actual face-to-face meetings as well. We know an awful lot gets done face-to-face when you develop those personal relationships, more so than virtual meetings, as we know in our own world of work as well. Dr. Jade McGlynn from the Henry Jackson Society, thank you for that. 9:32 is the time.